Ferrara under center, three back set, third down and goal, and Ferrara will throw over the middle, caught for a touchdown. That's Tim Brown, number 88, and Clifton takes the early lead. Low line drive kick taken by Giles at the 15, up the far sideline, and he might go. That's Darian Giles. They won't catch him. All the way down the sideline for a touchdown. No flags on the field as Passaic gets on the board. It is an 85-yard touchdown run on the kickoff by Darian Giles.
Sets at the belt, does H, and the pitch is hit in the air, deep to left field. Going back is Ramirez on the warning track. He makes the catch to end the inning. So Rusich gave it a ride. That would have tied the game had it gone about 10-15 feet further. And Kane narrowly escapes here in the bottom of the seventh. Going to be an interesting couple of last innings. Stay with us. Kane leads 9-6 on 91.3 FM WTSR.
Kutch inside. Kelsey Kutch grabs her own rebound, puts it up, no good. Two Kane players fight for the ball, and Jackson takes it away and moves up the court. Beirute for three, puts it in.
Now you can feel the momentum shifting again. Kane, Kane fans
back
into
to Kane. Timeout TCNJ. Kane back to a 14-point lead. 49-35, 12-48 left in the ballgame. Kutch inside to Klimowicz. He's fouled, and the shot is good.
A sky of blue and sea of green-clad fans greeted Jets players in Florham Park Saturday morning as the team departed its training facility for Sunday night showdown in Pittsburgh. Troy Bianchi of Wanacue did his best impression of linebacker Bart Scott.
Can't wait!
To the victor go the spoils, and the world champion Giants not only spoiled the Patriots' season on Sunday night, but took well-deserved jabs at some of their other rivals.
The last time we did this, we was in Giants Stadium. Now we're in MetLife Stadium. But for one thing, you can be sure of whose house it is.
That's captain and defensive end Justin Tuck.
Today's pregame show is brought to you by the Oakland Diner, a diner like no other in the area. Gourmet breakfast on the weekend beyond expectations with delights to please and prices too. The Oakland Diner does it like no one else, so meet me at the OD. The Oakland Diner, 72 Ramapo Valley Road in Oakland. John Fass and Pete Gilmartin will have the call of the game later on, and we'll go to them just before the top of the hour for a quick preview from the field. We will have updates from other games here in North Jersey throughout your afternoon as well. Greg Tartaglia will join us in a few minutes for a pregame look at DePaul visiting Paramus Catholic, and Jeff Costello makes his GHT sports debut as he watches Passaic at Passaic Valley. But Mike, let's start with our game of the week. You got into it a little bit. St. Mary makes the trek from Rutherford to play Saddlebrook. The visiting Gales come in with a record of 3-1. They got their season rolling with an impressive victory over defending North 1 Group 1 state champ Wallington, and they've just been going from there.
Well, my goodness, Casey Abel has been just a hitting star all year. Wasn't a huge factor in Saturday's win, but he's definitely someone that you cannot overlook. Mike Tallarico had a great game once again in the tournament, and this is where he makes his bones right here, the Passaic County Tech Field. We know what he did last year in the final against Passaic Valley with the two home runs, including the one that capped the big comeback and tied the game. But, you know, Abel and Tallarico, who I expect to go 3-4 in the order respectively today, are the big guns that you have to watch out for, and you cannot overlook them.
Point to make about Sheree Cooper. She is third all-time in Division III rebounds, and get this, she is 14th all-time NCAA history, any division in rebounding.
Coach, my last question is going to be for you. In your regular season finale against Hasbrouck Heights, I talked to Robbie Myers after that game, and one of the things that I said to him was, in late August, early September, your field was under 6 feet of water, and there's been a lot of damage in the community. And what does that mean to the community for you guys to put together such a great season and win it for the town of Pompton Lakes?
Well, everything's tremendous. I mean, everybody in Pompton Lakes pulls for each other.
Excellent. Thank you guys so much. Nico Torres, Jack Baumgartel, and head coach Scott Mahoney. John, we'll send it back up to you.